I'm on. In pointed public remarks, Jordan's Kean Abdullah II told Vice President Pence on Sunday that he had repeatedly warned Washington about the risks of recognizing Jerusalem as Israel's capital and that he hoped the United States would now reach out and find the right way to move forward. At a meeting at his palace in the Jordanian capital Amman, Abdullah began by welcoming Pence and said that discussions between the two longtime allies would be candid and frank at a time that he described as a very critical point for the region. He said that he had been encouraged by President Trump's commitment to bring a solution to decades of conflict by Israelis and Palestinians, but that Jerusalem is key to achieving peace. "Sir, I had continuously voiced over the past year in my meetings in Washington my concerns regarding the U.S. decision on Jerusalem that does not come as a result of a comprehensive settlement to the Palestinian-Israeli conflict," he said, addressing Pence and his delegation from across a dining table. "Today we have a major challenge to overcome, especially with some of the rising frustrations," he said. He added that it was very important to find a way to move forward with a two-state solution with East Jerusalem as the capital of a Palestinian state. "Your visit here, I am sure, is to rebuild the trust and confidence," he said. Pence responded by thanking Kean Abdullah for his warm hospitality and repeatedly referred to him as a friend. "We are here to reaffirm our friendship and our partnership and our great respect for you," he said. Pence's regional tour is partly aimed at smoothing over relations with U.S. allies in wake of President Trump's controversial decision to recognize Jerusalem as Israel's capital. Pence said before he left for Egypt this weekend that he hoped that the U.S. Jerusalem decision would help rather than hinder a peace deal between Israelis and Palestinians. But the Palestinian leadership has reacted with anger to the decision, and have refused to meet with the vice president. Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas has said it spells the end to the United States being a broker for the peace process. Israeli Arab parliamentarians also said they would boycott his visit to Israel, where he is scheduled to land on Sunday night. Speaking to Kean Abdullah on Sunday, Pence said that Trump's decision to recognize Jerusalem was historic, but that the United States is committed to continuing to respect Jordan's role as the custodian of the city's holy sites, and that the United States has taken no decision on boundaries and the final status of the city, which is subject to negotiations. While Trump said that was the case as he made his announcement on Jerusalem, he appeared to contradict that in a tweet earlier this month by saying that Jerusalem was off the table for negotiations, drawing further ire from Palestinians. "The United States of America remains committed, if the parties agree, to a two-state solution," Pence said. "We are committed to restarting the peace process, and Jordan does now and has always played a central role in facilitating peace in the region." Ayman Odeh, head of the joint list representing Israel's Arab parliamentarians, said Sunday that his faction of 13 lawmakers would likely stage a walkout as Pence speaks to Israeli parliament, known as the Knesset, on Monday. "Trump is whimsical, even racist," said Odeh. "But Pence, with his evangelical ideology, is very dangerous. I do not want him to come here, give a speech and we all sit quietly and applaud him," he said. "There are some people in this country that want to say to him that he is not welcome here. We want peace, with a Palestinian country next to Israel. Sitting quietly and listening to him is giving him legitimization. We want the Americans to know that there are some Israelis who do not see him as legitimate." At the start of his weekly cabinet meeting, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said it was a disgrace that certain Knesset members were planning to boycott or disrupt Pence's important visit in the Knesset. "We will all be there and share the great honor that he deserves," he said. Netanyahu said the two would discuss Trump's efforts to curb Iranian aggression and the Iranian nuclear program, as well talk about peace and security. "Those who truly aspire to these goals know that there is no substitute for the leadership of the United States," said Netanyahu. Palestinians in the West Bank and Gaza will likely stage protests to coincide with Pence's visit, while a few dozen demonstrators gathered in front of the U.S. embassy in Jordan on Monday carrying flags and banners. Israeli politicians, however, have largely welcomed the U.S. Decision on Jerusalem and Pence will be welcomed at Tel Aviv's Ben Gurion Airport on Sunday evening by Tourism Minister Yair Levin.